Okay. It's now recording. Let me start over here by the PowerPoint. And from the PowerPoint, the starting point is supposed to be what I'm going to talking about, what you have studied about the theory and what you are going to study. That is going to be experiment, or most of the time we call it like a testing. What about the theory? There is two main subjects that you have studied is the engineering statics, and another one is the mechanics of material. What you have here is based on Newton's third law and Newton's second law, right? What you have now is going to talking about the free body diagram and the equation of equilibrium. And what we have is the summation of the force equal to zero, right? And based on this, okay, let us talk a little bit small example about a beam that we have in the static, and also we have in the mechanics of material. Let this beam subjected to the 10 kilonewton and have 4 meter span. And this beam is supported by what so called the pin and roller. And then you have what? Under the pin, the beam will have the reaction of A sub X and A sub Y and B sub Y. You have the total reaction of 3. So we have the unknown reaction of 3. And by the same thing, based upon this, you have what? You have 3 equations with 1 free body diagram. And then the unknown is equal to the equation. We call this structure statically determinate beam. This is going to be the beam that can solve by using the equation of equilibrium, right? And then by doing that, you can find the A sub X equal to zero. And by the symmetry of the structure, you will find A sub Y equal to 5 kilonewton and B sub Y equal to 5 kilonewton, right? And then later come the shear diagram. Shear diagram is diagram that show the distribution of the shear forces. So this is X meter. Start over here by the point A on the left hand side. And then this is going to be 2 meter. This is 4 meter. And you have the knowledge about drawing this, right? We have what? We have 5 kilonewton. So over here, this is going to be +5. And then there is no uniformly distributed load on this portion of the beam. So what we have here is dV by dx equal to zero. You got to say that. And then what you have is the value of the shear is going to be constant of +5. And then at the middle length of the beam, you have 10 kilonewton downward. So that means the 10 kilonewton gonna take this one downward is going to be -10 plus what you have over there is 5. That is going to be -5. And then there is no distributed force. Again, over here you have dV by dx equal to zero. This one gonna be the constant of -5. And as the point of B, there is 5 kilonewton here, that is upward. So now you have V max to be +/-5 kilonewton, okay? And then for the moment diagram, again, you're taking care of this at the X meter, that's going to represent moment for kilonewton meter. Since this is pin, this is roller, there is no external moment. So you know immediately the moment here gonna be zero and the moment here gonna be zero. And by doing this, you have the relationship of what? Of the dm by dx equal to v. Since v is plus 5, so it's going to be the slope like this. It's always constant slope. Okay, and then the moment here, minus zero here, equal to the area over here. That is 5 times, this is 2, so that is gonna be 10 kilonewton meter. This is going to be here, okay? And then if you go further, the shear here is minus 5. You have the dm by dx equal to minus 5. And since it is minus, so the shape of this moment diagram going to have the negative slope. It's going to be down under it, right? And then you got what? You got the M max equal to 10 kilonewton meter. That is what? That is static. That the engine static didn't tell you anything about the material. What the material you are going to use, it say nothing. Okay, now you come the mechanics of material. The mechanics of material talking something about the material. It said the material that's under our consideration will have the linear elastic behavior. Also, the material under our consideration will have small deformation for under this, the moment produce what's so called the normal stress, and the shear produce what's so called the shear stress, and the tau max will come from the equation of V max times Q max divided by IT. What, you have it already? I just like to ask you, do you have still this kind of knowledge with you? But don't worry, you will have it again in this subject, and you also have it again in the reinforced concrete design and in the steel and timber design. You still work a lot on this. So under this is come to sigma max. Sigma max also come from the M max times Y max divided by I. Up until here, the theory didn't talk much about what kind of material are you using, okay? And then on the theory of structure, we talking about the architectural plan. We talking about the owner needs. And then we come to the selection of the material, right? So by talking with the owner, talking or owners, talking with the architect, you will have a chance to start by selection of material. You may select the steel, you may select the reinforced concrete, you may select the prestressed concrete. Now, it's come to the what so called, what kind of material are you using? For example, if this beam is going to be the steel beam, okay? Now, on the design of this, you start to need the results of the experiment, which we call it the stress strain diagram. Okay, this test diagram come from the testing of the material. And this kind of testing of material must follow some specific standard. For example, the TIS. And in the examination, I may ask you, what is for the TIS? Is going to be Thai Industrial Standard, or is going to be Thailand Industrial Standard? Something like that. Okay, that is multiple choice. You just select one. Or if you come to the national international work, you also need to work with the ASTM. That is going to be American Society of Testing and Materials. Aware about the S. I will have a lot of wrong writing. Supposed to be S somewhere. See, it's going to be multiple choice. A, B, C, D, E. Okay, I just manipulate the wordings. It may be Thai Industrial Standard. It may be Thai Industrial Standard. It may be Thailand Industrial Standard. It may be Thailand Industrial Standards. Or it may be Thai Industrial Standards. Something like this. Okay, you understand me, right? So please know about this. It's important because when you go to work with the foreign company, you got to be owner, okay, the standard by knowing what it means. And then the behavior for the linear elastic behavior is going to be here. Within the linear elastic behavior, the structure usually on this one, usually the purple one, have very small deformation. It will come together. So most of the time we limit our consideration to what we said is going to be sigma sub y. Based upon this, you design steel beam. You design the steel beam based upon the sigma allowable equal to the test result of sigma sub y divided by factor of safety. And then you set this one equal to sigma allowable. And by setting this one to be equal to sigma allowable, you know Mmax from this one. You know sigma allowable from here. And then you write the I over Y equal to section modulus. And this one is going to equal to a number. And then you use the steel table. Use the steel table. Where the steel table come from? Manufacturer. In Thailand, if you select the one from the SCG, Siam Cement Group, that is going to be Siam Yamato Steel Industry. Okay. If you prefer to use the Sahavidya Steel Industry, you're going to select the SVI manufacturer. Okay. By doing this, just pick up the section that has the S larger than the S required. It's going to have some specific conditions such as the lightest width. Okay, you may set GH, the lightest width. Because usually if you select the lightest width, the construction will be easy. The cost of the beam got to get cheaper, okay? It's going to be easy for the worker to handle the light beam, right? That is mostly, it is the condition that we use. Based upon this, what the engineering call is, we decide the beam. We decide it based on strength. This is based on the strength of material. And then you select the section, and then you check the tau max, which is going to be V max, and then divided by the A web, right? It's I section. The A web is the area of the web. That's supposed to be less than what? The strength of the material is going to be tau sub y divided by factor of safety. And where is tau sub y? Where is tau sub y come from? It's come from the torsion test. Okay, people and people we're going to take care. That is going to come from the torsion test. And how about the sigma sub y? That is will come from the tension test. Okay, and we will discuss that later. Okay, and then that means we finish our design basis on the strength. There is two strength. One is strength based on sigma sub y, and another one is the strength based on tau sub y. And then you got to decide or check it actually based on the what's so called stiffness. As you may know, under the application of the force, our beam will deflect. Okay, and then the theory based on the mechanics of material, we can find this one as the Vmax is going to be PLQ divided by 48 EI. To do this, we're going to have the Vmax equal to the P, this 10 kilonewton. The L is going to be the total of 4 meters. The I, you already select the section it. So this one is going to be PLQ over 48. And then the E. The E is going to be the subject that we are interested in. What the E is? It's going to be the slope on this portion. And we said this is E. This is E is what is going to be modulus of elasticity, right? For the steel, that E sub S is going to be 200 gigapascal. I can ask you in the examination, what is the approximate value of the modulus of elasticity of steel? What is the approximate value of the modulus of elasticity of the concrete? Okay, what is the approximate modulus of elasticity of timber or wood? That's going to be 3 questions already, right? And you got to be know about it as an engineer, okay? And I don't know what happened, it's still going back already. This one is what? This one gonna time the eye. And I know already, this is gonna be less than or equal to L divided by 240. This is okay. But if things are opposite, the Vmax is larger than L over 240, you need to redesign the beam. And the section gonna get what? Bigger. When you design the beam, just select the bigger section. That means it's going to be heavier than the previous one. That is the important between the theory and the material testing. You have the result of material testing to use it in the design of the structure. You also use the material testing to check the material that ship or transport to your site. To your construction size, right? Okay. Then we come to the chapter 3. That is going to talking about the testing procedure. Okay. In the testing, just take a look at your syllabus. We have many kinds of testing. If Ajahn putting this in the examination, what is going to be what this picture going to be in what kind of testing? This is going to be in tension test, right? And then this is usually for what the tension test? Tension test usually used for the steel. Why don't we do the tension test for the concrete? We didn't use much concrete in tension. However, if you have the concrete spec cement, you will have it in what's so called the compression test. That's mostly we did this for the concrete because the concrete used a lot for compression member. Okay, and if I do this, you will know this is going to be for the what's so called the flexural test. Okay, some people says this is going to be fracture, but some people said, can I call it bending? Yes, you can call both. Okay, it can be fracture test or bending test. And now if you recall from what I did show you a little bit from the bending testing, you will test for steel. You will test this for cast iron. You also test this for timber, right? There is a lot of material testing for this. And then if you draw the free body diagram in this picture, you have the force that's applied here, and there is the resistance like this. This is going to be the shear test. This is going to be what's so called the direct shear test, right? And for this one is what? It's going to be double shear. That's going to test for what? You will test this for the brass. You will test this for the copper. You will test this for the aluminum. Okay, there's also a lot of metal for the direct shear test. And not enough, from the test you also has another one. If you test the shear for the wood or the timber, you just put this one lock in the specimen holder, and then you put the force that cut to this point. What happened is the wood will crack along kit grain. The wood have the grain like this, okay? And this is going to be single shear test. And we are going to test this one for the timber, okay? And do we still have another test? Yes, we have another test that is in the corner of the room in the F5. That we have is what is the spec cement. And then you put the torsion into it. Okay, this is what? This is going to be torsional test. And then we're going to do for the material of what? This one we will do for the steel, and we will do it for the cast iron. Okay, wow, that's kind of a lot of things, Ajahn. Not yet. Each kind of testing, you require to know this one, sigma is equal to the force divided by the A, right? The stress occur here is the force divided by A. And the same thing as a compression, you can use this equation to determine the stress. However, when you change this one to the fractional testing, the equation gonna be sigma equal to my over I, okay? And then if you come to the shear test, you will have this one for tau equal to V over A. However, if this one is P, the V is going to be P over 2. So this one gonna be P over 2A for the double shear. For the single shear, the tau is going to be directly the force P. That is going to be P over A. And then when you come to the torsion, this one going to be tau equal to TR over J. Up until this point. How many things you have remember from what I'm lecturing? Okay, it's up to you, right? You come here to learn. You come here to be the graduate. And you're supposed to graduate with some knowledge out. And then that is going to require the testing procedure. That's for the different kind of tests. Okay, and then we're going to talk about the type of the testing, the experimental design, the specimen selection, and the preparation and testing machine, instrument, and equipment. The tension test requires the universal testing machine, right? It's maybe 120 kilonewton, and it's maybe the one in the F1 building. You guys did the tension test already, right? That means you also need to select the testing machine. And did you do the preparation of the testing machine? No, actually there is P who is tall, that's prepare for you, right? But did you prepare for the specimen? Have you ever have a chance to put the plow on the specimen to get the mark? No? P also prepare for you, right? Okay, anyway, you just remember that. Anyway, but most of the time, engineer didn't do it. We're going to hire the guys like him, do the test, but you are going to read the result, okay? And then come to what I just mentioned, the theory and the material testing result. They are all important for the design of the structure, okay? Both the theory, the equation, will be used with the mechanical property in order you to select the section of, for example, of this purlin. Let's say, you know the purlin, right? Purlin is just on the top, okay? And then by doing this, just go back to the first page of this, review the design basis on strength, review the design basis on the stiffness, okay? All of the design for the strength and design for the stiff must be passes, okay? And then you will get the appropriate section for this. And for this one, have you ever chance to do the modeling of the roof? This structure is going to be very easy. That's going to be study in what? In the theory of structure, right? And then the metal sheet, the roof metal sheet, will distribute all the loading into this. What the load on the roof? On the roof is going to have the dead load. That is the weight of the metal sheet. And also the life load. Where the life load of the roof come from? The wind, yeah, the wind. And the someone who go over there to fix the roof, right? We prepare for it. And then you can you transfer this into the one that's W acted on the purlin. And then you make the assumption the purlin is going to be statically determined purlin. Let's say it's going to be what? It's going to be modeling like this one. Your purlin gonna subjected to uniformly distributed load. Since this loading strip, if you take a look at it, it's going to be a long loading strip. When it's long loading strip, it's going to be the one-way action. If it's going to be a square or big rectangular, it's going to be two-way load distribution. Okay, by doing this, you're going to get this one, and then you use the theory to draw the shear diagram and draw the moment diagram. This is going to be the same shape as this one. No, it's one, right? The shear diagram and moment diagram of this is going to be something else. Anyway, under this, you may model it like this, and then the structure will deform also. And then you can find the Vmax again. The Vmax this time change to be this equation. And based upon this, it require you to find the E in order you to find the Vmax. Okay? And then you just check this one with respect to what the building code spec specified. That may see L over 240 if under the beam has no wall, okay? And if under the beam has a wall, what the V allowable is if there is a wall? That is going to be L divided by what? 360, okay? Okay, now just review it, okay? We're going to get the Sigma allowable. This is come from the test and is going to come from what from the theory, both from the theory and the test gonna work together in order you to do the design of the section. This one from the test, this one from the theory, okay? And then for example, if I said the sigma allow to be, for example, sigma allow is going to be 240 megapascal. I use factor of safety of 2.5. This one gonna be 100 megapascal. Ajahn, can you use 2.5? Yes, it's up to the owner. If they like it to be very, 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 very big, very, very durable. Okay, you may use a big number of factor of safety. The what so-called the factor of safety in the design code, that is the minimum. If it said 2 over there, you can use any number that's larger than 2. It's not wrong. But you cannot use the factor of safety less than what's specified in the design code. For example, if it said 2.0, you cannot use 1.5. Understand me, right? That is illegal. Ah, okay. And then what you have, this one is going to be 100 megapascal. From the analysis of the structure, they are under the application of the force, we can find the, what we can find the reaction, and also we can draw the shear diagram, and then we can draw the moment diagram. The maximum moment will occur at this point when the shear is zero. Why? Because over here, dm by dx equal to v and equal to zero. When the slope equal to zero, the function going to get maximum or minimum. Okay, it will get the maximum if the curve like this, and it will get the minimum if the curve like this, but our curve is like this, so it's going to get the maximum, okay? And then let the M max gonna be 10 kilonewton meter, okay? Now, from the theory, you get this value. So what we have is the I. If we set the section like this, so like this, the I over here gonna be B. It's going to be B. And this is going to be 2b cubed over 12. So the I is going to be in the form of 2b, not correct. Yes, it's correct, b power 4. This is b times b power 3. It's going to be b power 4. And then you put it like this. And then you get it for 0.053. So what you have over here, this is going to be 0.053 meter, or it's going to be 53 millimeter. And this one is going to be 106 millimeter. When you open the timber table, are you going to have this kind of section? Most of the time, no. You select the one that bigger. For example, you select the one with 55 × 1010 millimeter is okay. You cannot select 50 × 100 millimeter. This is smaller. It's no okay, right? You select the bigger one. You select the bigger one. And then by doing this, that means what? That means your structure can resist the maximum moment. Now, you still have the Vmax. Next, you check, okay, the tau max equal to Vmax Qmax divided by IT. But if the section is the square, you remember what is going to be? 1.5 V max divided by A, right? And then you can find it. If the tau max less than what we have from the lab of tau sub Y divided by factor of safety, this mean it's okay. It's big enough. If not, you need to redesign it. The section gonna get bigger. Okay, at this point, we call this strength design. Or you said is the size basis on strength of what? Strength of material. Okay, that mean the tau sub y and sigma sub y. And again, you come back to the chapter 12, right? Of the mechanics of material, you have this table. And if your structure subjected to a kind of forces, depend on if this is the force that's applied to the beam, you will have the Vmax equal to PLQ over 48 EI. And then the P, you know, right? The L, you know, the I, you know, only the E. You put the E from the test and then check again, that is going to be okay. If it's okay, the section is okay. If it's not okay, pick up the bigger one. So the design mean you pick up the bigger section, okay, step by step. Ah, okay. That is what I'm start here. I'm starting here, I'm trying to explain the connection between theory and the material testing result. Okay, when we decide the structure, we use both. And then they come from the multiple choices. Up until now, let's say midterm examination gonna have the multiple problem about 60 something, it's about 60. And the midterm examination gonna cover 4 chapters. That mean some chapter will have a lot of question. For example, chapter 3 and chapter 4 will have the total more than chapter 1 and chapter 2, okay? And what I'm going to ask you, for example, what is the strength, okay? And then I just said, the strength can be this one, A, this is A, this is B, this is C, this is D, and this is E, okay? You must say, strength is the ability of the material that can resist the applied force without failure. Before that, we use what? We use the yielding stress, okay? For the steel, yielding stress for the steel. However, for the concrete, we use the, actually, it's going to be ultimate stress. And this one is also ultimate compressive stress for the concrete. for the steel is going to be yielding stress, and typically is the tensile yielding stress. Okay, and then for the second thing, the stiffness, right? Stiffness is ability of the material to resist the deformation. This is talking about the deformation under the applied load. This is going to be the resistance to the force without failure. This is resistance of the deformation. Okay, under the applied force. Stiffness is mean deform the material that's stiff. It means it's going to deform less. For example, steel is the material that's stiffer than the aluminum. The same section of the beam, the steel beam, going to have the small deformation compared to the aluminum beam. Okay, because of what? Because E sub S is 200 gigapascal. However, E sub EL is only 70 gigapascal, three times less. And then we come to the elasticity. What's so called the elasticity? You just recall for the rubber band. Okay, if you put the stress and strain here, most of the time when you put together like this, the first portion of this is going to be the elastic portion. And then the second one over here is going to be the inelastic. The green is inelastic. The black is elastic. Elastic means what? Within this range, the material has ability to deform under the applied force without permanent deformation. That means what? You pull the rubber band and the rubber band elongate for 5 centimeters. You take the load out. It's just recover to the same original range. Okay? And then what we have next is the plastic. The plastic is this kind of region. This kind of region is called plastic behavior, or also is mean called inelastic. That is two names, but the same meaning, plastic or inelastic. What it has is, this is the ability of the material deform permanently under the applied force without failure. When you pull the steel, and the steel behavior in the elastic region, okay, elastic region, and you take the force out, it's going back to the original length. Okay, let's say the original length is 10 centimeter. 10 centimeter is 100 millimeter. And then you apply the force, okay, it's change the length to 101. Okay, you release the force, that is going to recover to 100 millimeter. However, this time, you pull again, is going to go to 107 millimeter. Now, this behavior go beyond this to somewhere over here, okay? And then when you release the force, this one will be follow the path of the linear over here, okay? You have this one as so-called the elastic recovery. And you have this one is for what? This one for the permanent set. This one permanent set, okay? If the permanent set is big, that means the material has large plasticity. If you have small permanent set, that means the material has small plasticity. Okay, and the last one, we involve with the energy capacity. If we talking about the energy capacity, you may recall the modulus of resilience. Okay. The modulus of Lebesgue is the area, okay, under this portion of the curve. The modulus of Lebesgue is 1/2 sigma proportion times strain proportion. Okay. That is the ability of the material to absorb energy due to the applied force. It is important. If you design the guard rail of the bridge and then there is a truck hitch the guard rail and that is on the elevated highway. If the guard rail collapse, what happens is the truck gonna go down to the floor under the elevated highway. That is very dangerous. So if you work in the highway department, you're going to design the guard rail and then you're going to select the material that has high energy capacity. Okay. And most of the time we're going to design it by if there's one hit by a pickup, it's going to be okay. But if it's going to hit by the 18 wheeler, this one can be damaged, not failure, but the SM wheel is supposed to hold on the elevated highway. And then if the pickup hit, that is maybe very small damage to the guard rail. No need to fix. It depends on what you decided. If you decided for the big truck, okay, the pickup won't harm it. If you decided for the pickup, the 18 wheeler will destroy it and will go down the elevated highway. Okay. And then here come to this problem. What is going to be? I just switching something like this in the examination. I may ask you, what is the definition of strength? Okay. What is the definition of stiffness? What is the definition of elasticity? What is the definition of plasticity? What is the definition of energy capacity? Okay, I just put this one in so you can recall it, right? Or another way, I put the word like this: ability of material to be deformed permanently under the applied force. And I ask you, what is this? The definition of what? Okay, that is two way. That means I'm going to have at least 10 questions. And I will select only 2 or 3 to be asked you. 10 because of what? Because 5 by the definition and then the levers, right? Something could be like that. It's easy, right? Multiple choice. Okay, use your ability. Now, there is another thing coming to this stress strain diagram. What I'm going to ask you, there is a stress strain diagram. One is in tension. Another one is in compression. Let us consider the one in tension. Okay, in tension. From the picture, which material going to has the highest strength? Okay, from the pictures, huh? Low carbon steel, yep. How do you know that since the aluminum alloy didn't have the yielding? You recall the 0% offset, right? The 0% offset. By the 0% offset, you got to find what? 0% offset. That's used to determine the yielding of the material, such as aluminum, didn't have a clear yielding point. By doing that, you got to find 0.2 divided 100. That is going to be 0.002. That means what? This is going to be 0.005, right? This is going to be 0.0025. That is going to be very clear. You just take it and then you draw this one and then, yep, very close. This is the yielding for the aluminum. And this is going to be the yielding for the steel. See? Okay. You can find that, right? So, correct. The steel, the low carbon steel going to be the highest strength. Which one going to be the blanket, the third highest strength? The third, high strength. Which one? It's not aluminum. It's going to be cast iron. Okay, the cast iron. However, you may see the cast iron is fail like this. I may ask you again, which material on this section, which material is a brittle material? Okay, you can see these two fail immediately after it reach the height. That's called brittle material. The other call what? A ductile material. Okay, that is good. Okay, this is some question I may ask you. Which material is a ductile material? You said steel, aluminum, rubber. Would rubber be the ductile material? It's going to be elongated a lot. It can be deformed a lot. Ductile is mean it can deform a lot before failure. Okay, it's a ductile material. And then which one is a brittle material? You know it already, right? Which material is proper for use in tension member? Steel, aluminum, right? How about the cast iron? Cast iron is fail immediately. If you use this, you want to be really careful about it. But the cast iron, you see, it fail about 140, but when it come into compression, it fail nearly 400. That is 3+ time larger than in tension. Why? Why the cast iron has low tensile strength? Remember what I lecture you in the lab number 3 from the previous lecture? Cast iron has high percentage of carbon, and then the carbon and the steel won't merge into the same material. The carbon make the cast iron to have the micro crack. When you pull it, the micro crack just open, and then it will reduce the section really fast, and then the failure of it is abruptly failure. Okay, that's why it's a brittle material. However, when you compress it, the micro crack just close up each other, right? And also there is another thing. When you compressing, what happens is the side going to be get bigger. It's called bulge out. Okay, so the cross section only get larger also. That's why the cast iron can take a lot of compression. The same thing as the concrete. The concrete have the compression 10 times more than the tensile strength. For example, if your concrete has the strength of 24 megapascal, or for this one, maybe 50 megapascal, the tensile strength may be only 5 megapascal. So we didn't use the concrete in tension. We put the steel into the tension side of the reinforced concrete to let the steel work for the concrete. And that's why you got to hook it up. Hook it. You hook the steel for what? To make the steel hook to the concrete and it won't slip. If you won't put the hook into it, it may be slip. Okay, so when you draw the picture, don't forget the hook, okay? And then what is going to be the compression member? You know about that already. Which material is the stiffest? Which material is the stiffest for the tension portion? This is going to be the stiffest. Which one going to be the less stiff material? Rubber, okay? That means what? From this picture, I may make about 20 problems. and you may see this kind of picture, and then I can set for 3 problems, this kind of 4 problems to asking you this kind of question. And it's multiple choice. Okay, A, B, C, D, E. You may just cross your eye, mark it, when you don't know. Okay, just guess it. And then come to what we have in the test. I would say most of the time the testing classified by the loading. I know it previously. We have what? Tension, compression, fracture, or bending, and the direct shear, the single direct shear, the double direct shear, and then the torsion. Okay. What I like you to know is the free body diagram of each test. Second, the equation that you supposed to use in each kind of test. Okay, that's in the previous slides. Okay, and it's going to be really easy. The testing of this, I may give you the picture of the test. And you can see from the picture, this is the applied loading. And this is going to be the reaction. Since the force is three forces, we may call this one as the fractional test with the three points loading test. Okay. And then I ask you what is going to be the shear diagram, what is going to be the moment diagram of this. We also have the four point loading in which the force applied like this and the resistance like this. This four point loading is also popular for the large structure testing. I will have the picture show you later in chapter 4 of the theory of structure. That's the work of P. Chu Tong. Chu Tong tests the structure in four point loading setup. Okay. And then what we have a good thing for this one, okay, the shear diagram of this is gonna be like this, and the moment diagram of the four point loading is very special. The middle portion of the four point loading test gonna be in only the bending moment, no shear at all. So the failure over there will be only due to the moment. Unlike the three-point loading, what you get is the structure that has this kind of applied force. And then you have this one for the shear diagram, and then the moment diagram is like this. For the failure of this kind of setup, have some shear force involved with it. Okay, but since the lab set up for four-point loading is kind of more complicated compared to the three-point loading, for most of the time we select the three-point loading test. And then what you should have is what to find the Mmax from this. I am able to ask you about this because it is the related, okay, material we are using between static, edging static, mechanics of material, material testing, okay? So review everything, make things know word to be the sophomore graduate after ending of this trimester, okay? You're going to be the sophomore graduate. Right? It's called so more question. And again, type of testing. What this one is what? This one, I give you the picture. This one gonna be tension test. Okay. The stress gonna be P over A. If I give you this picture, this one gonna be the compression test. And it's going to be for the concrete. And this one gonna be for the steel and also the cast iron, okay, in our test. And this one is for what? This is the old machine, the old picture. This one is for the torsion, okay, tau equal to op, T R over J. And then the last one is for what? This one is for the flexure. It's the 3-point loading. Okay. And I like you guys to go back to practice drawing your free body diagram of this kind of testing. You can do it. Okay. Really simple. And what you're going to follow, the tension test, you're going to follow the TAS. Okay. That is forcing the TAS that you're going to be interested in these four of them. I may ask you, based on the TIS, which property of the steel that are important? No, actually, that is important. I will give you only one of this. I say that is going to be, let's say, A, B, C, D, and E. See, that is multiple choice. The answer is going to be, then it will be C. Okay, answer is going to be, which mechanical property that we don't consider basis on the TAS is going to be that we don't, but we won't, don't, but we don't consider basis up on the TAS. Which one? A. Okay. See, this is two problem already. I can do a lot of things like that. Just copy and paste, copy and paste, copy and paste, and change it. Okay. Just make things like that. Okay, and come into the comparison. Also, I can ask you which mechanical property is important for the comparison test of concrete. Okay, I may say, okay, if that's, I may say, that is going to be, let's say, A, this is going to be B, this is going to be C, this is going to be D, and this is going to be E. Your answer is going to be A, right? The modulus of elasticity of concrete, not the modulus of resilience. And then we come the author. I also can ask you, this mean what? On this section, I may provide you 5 problem easily. Just let you consider it, okay? And also in the examination, I will allow you to have the A4 page. You can bring your A4 page, the A4, okay? Take note everything, 4 chapter, just only for one side. The back side gonna be blank, okay? This note must be handwritten, You may write by your own. It can be as small as you like. Put everything into it. Or it may be big if you like, okay? But the problem, if you put it very small, you will not find it. Because all of knowledge gonna be in that one page. You need the something to find, okay? You understand me, right? You have one page to allow it. And people, please talk with people, okay? And we will provide this page with the signature, okay? And a stamp, you can use only this page. And the people will come and provide to you in this class later. So you don't need to make it yet. We will have it on the 6th week. This is 3rd week, right? And next week, we don't count. That means we will have like a month until the Saturday the 8th, right? And that is going to be 7 p.m. 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. That's 2 hours with 60 something multiple choice. And we have additional handwritten, okay, exact question. It's going to be very similar to the second problem of the midterm examination of the mechanics of material. Second problem of the midterm examination. It's going to have the test diagram, right? Asking you to determine the mechanical property. And then they're going to give you a specimen, the structural member, and asking you the elongation under the force. And then asking you about the elongation after release the force. The standard thing, okay? Don't write every example into your note. Don't just write the step of calculation, please. It won't be the same, okay? It's a check. Just put the step, that's more than enough, or the concept, okay? Okay, up until now, again, we classify the test basis upon what's so called the static test. Most of the tests that we have, except one of people, except the fatigue test, we call all of them static tests. Okay, what I wrote previously are static tests. Only fatigue test is not static test. And then do we classify the fatigue test? Fatigue test is not dynamic. We don't have dynamic test here. The dynamic test usually studied by the metallurgical engineering. Okay, that specimen will be here. Okay, and then the hammer is here. You release it, it's going to swing back and hit it, poke, okay, and see the behavior of this one. And the long term, this long term actually not study here, but you supposed to study it in the concrete technology test. You're going to put the concrete over here, okay, and then you twist this one and you hold the load for 7 days. And then you measure the deformation during 7 days. If the deformation keep going up, that means the concrete have high creep. Is it good? The column is going to shorten all the time. Until some now, it's going to hit your head, something like that. No, it's not good, right? So the creep supposed to be small. Where the creep come from? Thinking about the concrete. The concrete is the mix of cement, water, sand, crushed stone, and you mix in the mixer. During mixing, there is the air coming to the concrete. Okay, if there is a lot of air, the concrete will have a lot of creep. How to reduce this? There is an additive called air enhancing agent. Put some special chemical into it. The air will be separated into a very small air, the big air. Okay, the big void will be reduced to a very small void. That will help reducing the creep, okay? And the last one, based on the cycle, most of the tests that we have in the lab is one cycle test. However, the fatigue test is the only one that's subjected to repeated stress, okay? That's only one that's have more than one cycle. This one, the author just one cycle test. And then come from the testing condition. The concrete that we use, the steel that we use, usually is used to build a structure like this. Like what? It's set up in a good condition, unlike some structure that's in the sea. Okay? Some structure may be built in the area that's very cold, like the North Pole, right? That's kind of special thing. Most of the concrete that we are talking about is the concrete will test as 25 degrees Celsius. How about if the concrete used in the Northern Sea, that's also wet and cold. That is special. that requires special test of concrete. You got to simulate the condition there and test the concrete with that condition. Okay, there is something like low temperature. Not only the North Pole that's cold, there is some storage room, cold storage room, especially for the vegetable and for the meat. Okay, they are very popular now, the frozen meat and the cold vegetable and fruit, right? That's going to make it fresh. And that structure will subject it to low temperature. How about the author for the high temperature? Thinking about you are building the cement production factory. What the cement production? You crush or you bust the log, okay? And then you mill it into a small piece of log and you fried it. And when it's fried to some special size, and you put some admixture into it, you put that mixture into the kiln, K-I-L-N. And then that is going to use about 800 degrees Celsius, okay, to make the reaction of the limestone and some mixture produce the cement. That's really high temperature, okay? The structure that support the kiln, เตาเผาปูนแล้วคิว so it requires some special concrete. Talking about the steel company, not only the cement, steel company also, the ingot, leg dip, ingot. Thailand won't have the iron ore mining in Thailand. Thailand don't have, do you have it in Cambodia? The America don't have it. Most of the time we ship it from Brazil, Russia, okay, if high quality from Germany. And then we put that into the ingot, leg dip. We put that into the electric furnace arch to make it from the solid piece into the liquid. And putting some additive, chromium, vanadium, those kind of thing to improve the quality of the steel. That's also really hot, right? That structure also require the test in high temperature. The other thing, thinking about P-bond. P-bond is the battery. P-bond working for the PTT exploration. He is, I think he's the only one that's working in this company to looking for the gas and oil in the ocean. So what he working is in the sea, right? So the concrete structure that he used to build the leak, the oil leak, requires some special tests. And some people may chasing from some elemental engineering student, girl. You may chase for a girl. Chalut, Chanat, pay, jeep, sao, sing, wet, long. You are going to build the water treatment plant. What is in the wastewater? Is some kind of inorganic thing, right? Or is maybe some kind of chemical agent. So the concrete of the water treatment plant also requires some special consideration. Okay, that means you may put that concrete into the wastewater for 30 days. After that, you pull it out and test it to check the mechanical property gonna be the same or not, something like this. Okay, and then when you do the experiment design, for example, if one of you as the international student work for the Airbus in Europe, or you may work for the, what's it called, Boeing? I don't know, I don't know how to spell it. It's okay, the Airbus is enough, okay? For the airplane company. In the airplane company, they require a lot of material, right? To build the airplane. And if the airplane just crash, went down by a small piece of wing just broken during its flying at 10 kilometer higher than the sea level, what happened? All the people gonna be gone, right? Okay. Another one of you guys gonna be the owner of a small company, but But you are going to work for the DTAC. You know DTAC, right? DTAC. To install the transmission tower like this. The DTAC transmission tower also has the cable. Okay? Talking about this, when you consider this, if one of the cable may fail, the transmission tower may fail also. But it's going to be really dangerous to 100 people, like the airplane. No, it may hit my head or your head. Only one or two people going to get dead. But the airplane won't. If you go to the big airplane like 777 or 747, those kind of old airplane, when it fails, 200 or 300 people are going to lose life, right? So when you consider this, it's going to come from the importance of the structure you are going to use the material. And then you're going to get, for this one, going to get the high reliability of test. For this one, the test must be repeated. For this one may require higher accuracy and precision. And this one maybe have a lot of money to test, right? Test in different conditions. Unlike this one, it's maybe less important. So less precision is maybe require less expenditure of the test. So the expo design is based up on this consideration. However, finally, the most important thing is the experiment or the test must follow the standard, okay? For the Boeing, for the Airbus, for sure it's going to follow the Euro code. You know, the European code, right? The European code. If you come to this one, it's just follow the TIS, that's enough. Then just asking you. Let us consider a structure. You are an engineer. Your dad asks you to design a building that has the steel roof. You decide use the truss at the steel roof. The question that I'm going to ask you, what are the mechanical properties you are going to use in the design? I just talking about this from the start of this lecture. Do you record it? You're going to be the engineer? Chayut, P. Alut asks you, Chayut, you study material testing with Ajahn Sithichai. You get this project. I give you 10,000 baht for the design and construction of this project. I'm going to use the steel. P. Alut asks you, hey, use steel. What kind of medical property you're going to use? You may say, okay, P, I'm going to use this. Modulus of elasticity, yielding stress, ultimate stress. I ask you again, following the TAS, that's all the mechanical property we are going to use. It's going to require one more, which is? Open elongation, the one that's going to be elongated a lot. That is 10,000 baht project. He's supposed to be give me the correct answer. And then we are going to use the tension test because it's the steel, right? Steel. Why don't it put in the compression test? You see the testing machine, right? In the lab F1, when it's pulled, the wet grip the steel. Thinking about when it's in compression, it's going to be very hard to do the test because the grip will lose itself. The test is going to be more complicated. So most of the time we do the tension test. And then how you relate it? Yes, I get the yielding stress from the lab. So in the design, I'm going to use the sigma allow in which is going to be sigma sub y divided by factor of safety. So you use factor of safety to make your structure more reliable, stronger. Okay, and then there are a lot of things you may use. Which one? This one we should not use in the test. It's produce a lot of error, right? You got to select the UTM. Okay, and then the accuracy, the kind of testing, you got to follow the testing specimen. You got to follow the TIS, or you got to follow the TSIF. Oh, you know this? Japanese industrial standards, or Japanese industrial standard, or is Japanese industrial standard? It's multiple choice. Yeah. Where is the S? Okay. Okay. And then a lot of you will feel very bad after you come out of the class. Why Ajahn putting something like this? Beware about that. Okay. How about the BS? British standards. Okay. You have a lot of standard. And also how many specimens you are required to use in the test. And then come home to the specification. We must follow what spec. The STM, you know it already, right? The TAS. Oh, there is another one, the wood. In Thailand, we use a lot of wood in the past. Now, the wood used in the rich people house or buildings. Rich people, they are rich because now the timber is very expensive. You may cut your wood, sell it to your friend. And we sell in Thailand, it's very high price, especially the teak, my thing, my sack. Okay, cut it from Cambodia, ship it to Thailand. We do the business together, right? I don't know you have how many forests you have, but in Thai, most of them gone, most of them gone already. And then. In the past, we ship a lot from Burma, to the north and to the Bangkok. Another one, you know DPT. In Thailand, it's more your poor. It's come from Gom Yotha Thikar Lek Phang Mueang, Department of Public Work and Town Planning. This is very important division. I have a friend in Ubon Ratchathani. He is the head of this one in Ubon Ratchathani. He supervised on the construction in Ubon Ratchathani. A lot of engineer working over here. And they have their own standard. And the timber in Thailand will follow that. And then when you use the specimen, just looking for the archetype of your testing, thinking about the airplane, and the transmission tower, okay? And then it's come to the level of accuracy, precision. That's come from the objective or important of the test. And again, it's also one that will govern the course of the test. This is not important. It won't be in the examination. And what do you measure in the lab? We measure the length. Or we also measure the angle of twist, okay? And we measure the applied force, also the applied moment. Most of the time, we just measure this. This is not in examination, okay? Which is going to be in examination? It's going to be this. What is this? One is systematic error. All of the measurement always has the error, but the error are separate into two types. One systematic, another one, let me call it random error. Random error and the accidental error are the same. Thing is like this, in your lab group, that is four people, right? If I give one of you the vernier, to determine the diameter of this. Okay, Mr. A, measure it, take a note. Mr. B, measure it, take a note. Mr. C, measure it, take a note. Mr. D, measure it, take a note. Do you think that's going to be the same value? No, it won't be the same value. It's going to be random error. It's depend on the one who measure and read the vernier, right? Okay, understand the definition of this? Random error gonna be kind of natural error. And then by doing that, you're going to use the statistic to find the average, to find the standard deviation, to find the coefficient of variation. Okay, to taking care of this, thinking about you produce a steel and then you sampled it, 100 of them, and then you test it, okay? And then you use the mean to sell your steel. What happened is a lot of steel will come back to your company because of the rejection. If you use the mean, that means half going to be acceptable. Another half will not acceptable. That's why we go to the chapter 2. We're going to have the mean minus 3 or 4 SD in order that most of the specimen will pass the test and your product will never return to you. Okay, but the disadvantage thing is you're going to sell your steel with a lower mechanical property. Okay, but it's going to be more reliable. Again, that is for the accidental error or random error. When you produce thing, there is random error. Okay. Another one. Do you have a motorcycle? Okay. If you have a motorcycle, you like it 100 kilometers per hour. Okay. Kilometer per hour. And then the police is there. They use the laser gun to point you and measure the speed of you is only 90 kilometers per hour. You're not fine. It's okay. The speed is okay, but you kind of, I'm going to be catched because I ride my motorcycle faster than a 90 kilometers per hour limited. Okay. But if you like it, the bicycle for the mile, show 50 kilometer per hour. What the policeman, when he use the laser gun to check your speed, how many speed will show on the laser gun? It's going to be very easy. By this one, it's going to be symmetric error. You like it 100 kilometer per hour, the laser tell the police, that is only 90, right? So when you drive for the 50 kilometer per hour, this is going to be 45. This is systematic. When it's systematic, just do the proportion like this. Okay, that is all for today. Any question? And this is also going to be the examination, okay? I'm going to ask you what the accidental error mean. I will give you A, B, C, D, E. What is the systematic error means? A, B, C, D, E. Or I just give you this kind of example. Can you calculate it? For example, if my car, okay, drove at to Khon Kaen at 120 kilometer per hour, I see on my car, and then the policeman used the laser gun, and he found that I drove at 130, and he gave me the ticket. I'm going to be down, right? I find this many times with my car. I drove it at 120, but the ticket come with 125. I think this is 120. Why I know it? Because I use cruise control. Because when the highway is clear, okay, why don't use 120? But the ticket come with 125. So if I drive my car with 130 kilometer per hour, what the police going to give me with the ticket? That is going to be the examination, right? Use the proportion. For the accidental error, it's easy. We have the accidental error. I give four of you guys measure the length, okay, of the stair. And then I get the value of 1.21, 1.22, 1.23, and 1.24, which is going to be the average. 1.21, 1.22, 1.23, 1.24. Just put it into the calculator and answer me. Okay, let's have an example. What is going to be standard deviation? Can you compute it? Right? That is also go back to the chapter 2. So things are related to each other. I will come to the chapter 4 next lecture after the Songkran. Okay, chapter 4 will require 2 lectures. That means I'm going to finish every lecture on the chapter 5. Oh no, week 5. And then we have examination at the end of week 6. You have 1 week to prepare for your note. And let me give you this one. That's what we're going to have is May the 8th. Checking it is Saturday. And I have negotiation with my Thai student. They prefer to have examination at 7 p.m. They said it's Saturday. I'm supposed to wake up about noon, and still I have like a 6 hour to read your stuff. Okay, or you don't like it? I have work on 7 p.m. Some people need to work, but believe me, 7 p.m. is good. If 3 p.m., some people just wake up, don't have enough time to read stuff, and then you prepare for the A4. The PTA will distribute to you later. It's maybe after Songkran. Who won't attend that lecture will not get the A4. And you will come to the room with your brain only. Okay? And then you take it by your hand written and put your name and ID into it. You use it, okay, at the examination, and then when finish examination, please turn in the A4 to me. Why? I have some special thing, okay? Because some people really diligent, make it's very so small, take everything into one page, and then he did pretty bad on the examination, okay? And then he going to get F. That sheet will help him, not for the A, not for the one who going to get F. Okay, it's nearly never happened, but few of your senior has that problem before. So I should keep that. And then you cannot photocopy. You got to do by yourself. Okay, using the pen, you may use the red, blue, black, green, yellow, whatsoever color you like. Okay. Into that page. Any question on this? No? Okay. Have a good day and see you on Wednesday. No, on Thursday. On Thursday. We don't have a class on Wednesday, right? We don't. No. Wednesday is for Thai students and we have it on Thursday on the theory. And please, the theory going to be really quick. Okay, I'm going to end the handwriting examination. There are still part of it. We are going to taking look for the maximum compression and maximum tension. We didn't get the answer yet. Okay, after finish the example, I will go to the chapter 4. I upload the chapter 4 into into the Facebook already. And I'm going to upload the extra example. I will show you very important problem on the written the shear diagram and moment diagram for you. And the examination will be easier than what I'm going to show you. Okay? And believe me, I did finish the examination design and all of them easy. So easy. So easy. Okay, see you guys. Bye-bye. Have a good day. Buddy. Ah, okay.